So glad you guys are joining us, and if you tuned in last week to our TV camp episode, we are really grateful. Hope you guys are enjoying these every week. This week at camp was supposed to be studio camp. If you've never been to studio camp before, every team gets to make their own short film. So kids are starring in their own movies that they come up with. They're always really fun and crazy. And then on Friday, we have what's called the Straight Street Film Festival, where we premiere all of the movies that all the kids have made. So it's kind of a bummer that we didn't get to do that this week, but we have so many years of videos. We're actually going to get to watch one on our show today. We hope you enjoy it. So we have a very fun, kind of movie-themed show for you today. So we thought we should do this in kind of a movie feel. So instead of doing this normal, we thought we would do our show in a widescreen like a movie. So let's do that now. Are you ready? There we go. Now we're in a movie. Are you ready? It's time to let the show begin. To the movies here at Studio Camp. Last week we had our dress-up contest where we had kids dress up in their favorite costume of a TV character. This week, pretty obvious, we had kids dress up as one of their favorite characters from a movie. Here are the dress-up contest competitors for this week. Check them out. Way to go to all of our dress-up contest kids. Our winner of all those kids is Madison, dressed up as the Tin Man from one of my favorite movies, The Wizard of Oz. Madison, congratulations, you've won a pack of stickers from Camp Straight Street. We hope you enjoy them. Now we want to go on to the impossible shot, where we have a brand new impossible shot for you from my man, Aiden. Here is this week's impossible shot. Here comes Aiden on the trampoline. He's getting some big bounces. Look how high he's getting right here. Head just above the rim. Here comes the last jump. Eyes locked on the rim. Here it goes under the leg and...
here we go now.
Boom! That's how you do it, Aiden. Let's see that impossible shot again. Here we go. Boom! Aiden, that was incredible. Impossible shot. Congratulations, you have won a $5 gift certificate to Bluff Park Ice Cream and some stickers from Camp Straight Street. If you make an Impossible Shot, we want you to send it in, and you might be our winner each week on the camp show. So please, film your videos of an Impossible Shot. This doesn't have to be basketball. It could be a bottle flip. It could be golf ball. It could be ping pong, anything. Slam dunk a cat. No, don't do that. Anyway, do something really awesome. Send it in right here at Camp Straight Street, and we would love to feature it right here on our show. Now, one of the sad things about this whole kind of distancing thing and not having camp this summer is that we haven't gotten a chance to see a lot of people. You've gotten to see me, but you don't get to see your favorite people like Heather, and particularly Andrew. And honestly, I haven't seen Andrew in a very long time. You might have known this, but at the end of camp last summer, Andrew decided to make a slight career change. Andrew decided at the end of camp last summer, after being featured in our Studio Camp video, a video that actually won the Studio Camp Film Festival for the Orange Team Breaks the Internet, Andrew had a big role in that. I think he thought that this potentially could be the beginning of a new career for him in being a superstar. Well, I called Andrew this week and checked in on him to see how his new star celebrity search is going. And it's not going well. Check this out.
Andrew, are you there?
Listen, I don't know. I don't want. I do not want diet.
What are you
okay?
doing?
Hey.
What's up?
Well, you kind of caught me at a funny time. I'm out here at the. I'm on my island.
Your island?
Yeah. Listen, I know. Hard feelings about me quitting camp last year, but you know, I had a chance to be in Hollywood.
Yeah,
do you remember?
You were supposed to be in a movie or something, right?
Yeah, the Bandana Bandits.
Yeah, Bandana Bandits?
It was coming out this summer. It was coming out just like a few months ago. Have you seen it? Have you seen it?
Your movie was already supposed to come out?
Yeah, like just a couple of months. Like, they're supposed to send my check.
No. Do you not know what's going on?
What do you mean? Hold on, John. Wait. Now I want two more. No diet. Sorry, it's hard to get good health these days. You know.
Where are you?
No. What's happening?
Where are you?
No, I'm on my private island. I got it last year. My private island.
How did you buy
it? Right out in Cabo. Huh?
Your movie never came out.
John, dude, no. You trying to be a comedy?
No, like no movies have come out.
What?
Andrew,
what are you talking about?
No, all the
You saw me and the Bandana Bandits.
Andrew, no
my
one.
Famous line. You know the one. No, you can't do that. You know that. You remember that line when I was in the back? I was an extra.
Yeah,
you remember?
No one, Andrew, no one saw your movie.
What are you talking, Jonathan? Are you serious? Have you not seen the movie,
Andrew?
Are you
telling you all the theaters?
You haven't seen my movie because you're upset with me?
No, all the theaters are shut down.
From what?
The virus.
I'm on an island, Jonathan. There's no virus here. What are you talking about?
Well, that's great, but here where we are on the continental U.S., there's a virus. All the theaters are shut down. The restaurants have been shut down. Camp shut down.
What?
Yes.
I
no one saw your movie.
So how am I paying for this?
Did you buy the island thinking you would get paid for the movie?
Yeah, I was an extra in a Hollywood movie, The Bandana Bandit.
No, I heard that. I don't think one, you're going to get paid much for that movie, and two, if you're getting paid for the movie making money, it didn't come out. You have no money.
Well, John, can I ask you, Are y'all having camp next year?
Well, yeah, we're having it next year.
Is there a job opening?
Well, I mean, last summer at the end of camp, you stormed out of my office and saying, I'm going to go be a star. Look how bright I'll shine. And then you slammed it and said, forget this. Here come the movies. And now look at you. You've got no movie, and you're broke floating in a pool that you don't own anymore.
Nobody's – yeah, well, listen, that was all just – I was acting. I was acting at that point. I was practicing. So well, that's just water under the bridge, isn't it, right?
Not exactly. Listen, Angie, if you're going to come back, you got to come back at the bottom. You have to start off holding the hose for the water slide and build your way back up after that deepest speech you gave me.
I did that for so long. Nope. Please.
Listen.
Activity staff?
Yep. You got to go back to holding the hose and getting my coffee.
But I was in a movie. You remember? Hey, you can't do that.
No, no one saw that. No one heard your line. Hey, you can't do that. No one saw the bandana bandits or whatever it's called, the banana bandits.
It's the bandana bandits.
I got to be honest. If the virus hadn't happened, I still don't think people would have seen your movie, Andrew.
Are you sure? It's pretty good. It's got
maybe it'll come direct to video or direct to VHS.
Man, I hope it goes to VHS. I have to pay something for this island. Okay, John. Well, listen, I got to call my agent, and I got to get this figured out, man.
I would. Well, hey,
I don't want the guy. I don't want anything anymore. Y'all go home, please. I'm sorry. I got to take care of this. They're, like, thinking I'm paying them. And
yeah.
I can't. I just can't.
Yeah, I think you need to stop the movie star life.
I can at least keep the float, though, right? You think?
I would take the float and run, buddy.
Okay, well, all right. I'll see you later. Hey, next summer, okay?
Yeah, call me if you need a ride or something.
Okay.
Andrew?
Well, Andrew clearly did not shine as bright as he had hoped. That's okay. We always got a place for you back here, Andrew. Just come on back. Just come on back and join the group. Well, now we want to do some singing. We have a brand new song for you. Not a new song for camp. It's an old camp song, but new to our camp show. It's called Big House. Some kids call it My Father's House. It's got really fun motions, and if you know them, get up and do them with us. Here is a song that we like to sing at camp called Big House.
I don't know where you lay your head, or where you call your home. I don't know where you eat your meals, or where you talk on the phone. I don't know if you got a cook, butler, or a maid. I don't know if you got a yard with a hammock and a shade. I don't know if you've got some shelter, say a place to hide. I don't know if you live with friends in whom you can confide. I don't know if you got a family, say mom or dad. I don't know if you feel loved at all, but I bet you wish you had. Come and go with me to my father's house. Come and go with me to my father's house. It's a big, big house with lots and lots of rooms. A big, big table with lots and lots of food. A big, big yard where we can play football. A big, big house. It's my father's house. My father's house. All I know is a big old house with rooms for everyone. All I know is lots of land where we can play and run. All I know is that you need love and I've got a family. All I know is that you're all alone, so why not come with me? Come and go with me to my father's house. Come and go with me to my father's house. It's a big, big house with lots and lots of room. A big, big table with lots and lots of food. A big, big yard where we can play football. A big, big house. It's my father's house. My father's house. Come and go with me to my father's house. Come and go with me to my father's house. It's a big, big house with lots and lots of rooms. A big, big table with lots and lots of food. A big, big yard where we can play football. A big, big house. It's my father's house. A big, big house with lots and lots of rooms. A big, big table with lots and lots of food. A big, big yard where we can play football. A big, big house. It's my father's house. My father's house.
And we want to sing one more song for you, and that is the song, the Superman song. Here it is, the Superman song. Do the motions with us.
Where is Superman when you need a helping hand? Don't look for Wonder Woman when trouble's really humming in. Please don't look for Batman when it's trouble you must face. I highly recommend God's supernatural grace. Where is Superman when you need a helping hand? Don't look for Wonder Woman when trouble's really humming in. Please don't look for Batman when it's trouble you must face. I highly recommend God's supernatural grace. Supernatural, Jesus walked on the water. Supernatural, he made a highway through the sea. Supernatural, Jesus turned water into wine. Supernaturally. Where is Superman when you need a helping hand? Don't look for Wonder Woman when trouble's really humming in. Please don't look for Batman when it's trouble you must face. I highly recommend God's supernatural grace.
Now it is time to look back at years previous with something that we call the Camp Straight Street Retro Video Moment, where we look back at an old camp video. We're going to go back 2 years to 2018 Studio Camp to our Best Picture winner from the Red Team, a beautiful documentary called Rubber and Fear, The Great Dodgeball War, about a dodgeball battle that went down right here at Camp Straight Street that will live on in infamy. Here it is, Rubber and Fear.
Of course, I'm 13 now, but it felt like forever ago.
There was a lot of confusion in the trenches. We didn't know what was going on. We just heard them flying over our heads.
The smell of rubber filled the air. The smell of rubber and fear.
War is never expected. This was the case of the great dodgeball war between Red 6 and Red 7-8, a war which would test the hearts and minds of every Red Teamer and test the limits of the human spirit. The war lasted from Monday afternoon to Thursday evening, but for many, it felt like a lifetime. To understand how such a sprawling and impactful war began, we must begin our story with just two young men, and we must begin in a room called the bus stop, where games and friendship abound. In this room, two friends, Moss from Red 6 and Jacob from Red 7-8, could frequently be found playing their favorite game, the Super Smash Brothers.
Every time we walked in the bus stop, they were playing that game. It was like they were playing it for hours, but it's weird because we were only in there for 30 minutes.
You could tell these two were best friends. They really had a great time together.
It was always competitive at games, but it was always good fun. Why couldn't it just stay that way?
On Monday afternoon, after a particularly competitive game, an event occurred that would change the course of human history forever.
A trip. Moss stuck his foot out and Jacob tripped. Fell flat on his face. It was actually pretty hilarious.
Moss's foot, sprawled out over the path of Jacob's stride, sent Jacob plummeting to the ground. Everyone around him laughed, even Heather.
Now the question is, is it an accident, or is it on purpose? Let the footage be, do the talking. Here we go. This is the day of the tripping, and we can see that Jacob and Moss is right here. Now, Moss is leisurely sitting here on the couch, and as we walk through, we can kind of see where the foot actually takes place of the trip ensuing. Now, the question is, like we said, is it on accident, or is it on purpose? Let's see. So here we go. The foot really does come up quickly here. Now, was it on purpose? Up to you.
This would be the question that would lead to incredible sorrow and immeasurable loss. Jacob, being laughed at by the entire room, began shouting at Moss, blaming him for tripping him. Moss defended himself, insisting that the trip was an accident. Soon, every single Red Teamer would take a side, shouting at each other back and forth. Then, it happened.
We don't know who threw the first ball. It could have been both sides even. But what we do know is that that's what started everything.
First one dodgeball, then two. Before anyone knew what was happening, balls were being hurled in every direction. Total anarchy. Finally, when Monday came to a close, the Red Team had been divided into two factions. Red 6 became the Accidentalist Union Army, led by Moss. And Red 7-8 became the Intentionalist Militia, led by Jacob. As a new day began, the conflict had escalated to all-out war. The winner would have full reign over the bus stop until the end of time. The first command from both sides was to eliminate the counselors from the equation. They rounded them up and placed them in makeshift prison camps in the men's bathrooms.
Yeah, the counselors were making it really hard for us to have this war, so we just decided to go tie him up somewhere for a while.
I feel like once the counselors were out of the picture, it was a whole lot easier to get down to business. Made it a whole lot easier.
I mean, we tried to stop him. We really did, we just couldn't. We tried. We tried to stop him.
Next, the Accidentalists began a forward march on Intentionalist territory. They expanded from the garage and parking deck all the way down to the top of the stairs. The Intentionalists retaliated, flanking them and taking control of the slides and playground. By the end of the day, 20 soldiers on each side were out. The day was a draw. On Wednesday morning, the Intentionalists, stationed in the cafeteria, heard the sounds of horns. The Accidentalists charged. A diary of Private Brian Thomas of the Intentionalist Militia described the event.
Dearest Mother,
Earlier today, those klutzers got the jump on us. Lots of my friends are out of the game. It'll take a lot of catches to bring them back in, and I fear I may be out by the end of the day. Send snack packs, but not the sugar-free kind. Yours truly, BT.
The intentionalists were on the defensive. Jacob devised a strategy to maintain the control of the gym at all costs. Guards with stockpiles of dodgeballs were stationed in the secret locations behind cars in the parking lot. Meanwhile, Moss was executing a plan of his own to infiltrate the other side.
Both generals were really smart, and they knew what they were doing.
Man, their tactics were beyond anything we've ever seen in a dodgeball game.
These plans, you know, they really would have worked. But then we found out about the spies.
Wednesday evening, in the final act of the day, Jacob called a huddle, but he noticed something out of place. Two soldiers he did not recognize. He quickly realized what was happening. Moss had sent spies to uncover his plans. Many say the spies would have gone unnoticed if it weren't for their slightly different colored lanyards. The spies were quickly taken out, but Jacob had been pushed to his limits. What he did next was unprecedented.
I remember it was Thursday morning. We all thought it was going to be a normal day. Then Jacob gave the order. I think the order was necessary. It was designed to end the war, even if sometimes that means crossing lines that you wouldn't normally cross.
I think he should have never made that order. It was so monstrous, inhuman. I should have dropped out when I could.
The order in question was short and to the point. It read simply, "Gentlemen, aim for the head." On Thursday evening, the time had come. The two factions met on the final battlefield, the gym. Jacob and Moss spoke fire into the hearts of their soldiers, but only one side could come out standing. The clock struck three, and it began. The two sides charged at one another. Dodgeballs were lobbed overhead. Man after man fell to the floor. Moss was unprepared for Jacob's headshot order, and as a result, the accidentalists began to suffer greatly. Many injuries were sustained. Moss and the accidentalists held strong for 19 long minutes. But unfortunately, it wasn't enough. As the clock struck 3:20, Jacob and the intentionalists looked out to see a white flag being waved. The intentionalist militia had won. On Friday morning, the intentionalists entered the bus stop, alone.
We had free rein. There were no accidentalists, just us.
I remember I was playing Rocket League, and I looked over at Jacob. He looked completely different.
He looked lonely, really, really lonely. And I'm never going to forget this. He walked out and no one knew where he went.
We were all starting to worry at this point. But then he walked back through the door, and right next to him was Moss.
When he walked back in, we were obviously all very confused, but we started to realize something.
The game was intense, really intense, but it was still a game and we had fun playing it.
You can play the game and be competitive and try to win, but in the end, it's really all about having fun.
And I think in the end, it's all about friends. And Jake and Moss, the entire time, regardless of what happened, they were really good friends.
Many lives were changed by the Great Dodgeball War. There were dozens of scraped knees and countless grieving hearts. But perhaps the two lives changed the most were those of Jacob and Moss.
Well, way to go, Red Team. Great job on that film. That's one of my favorites. And now it's time to join in the fun. It's time to enter the game. Now, the game that we're about to play is called the Emoji Movie Game. Now, it's not a game about the movie, the Emoji Movie, because that movie was terrible. It's about emojis and movies. Here's how it's going to work. We are going to take some emojis that you would type on your phone and put them on the screen. You have to guess what movie we are trying to get you
to think about. Now, I'll give you a little hint. All of these movies are animated movies, so they're all cartoons. You might see some emojis that create the title of the movie, or maybe it's the main characters of the movie, or maybe it's the story. But put all of the emojis together and see if you can come up with the emoji movie that we are thinking about. Are you ready? Here's our first one. Check it out. All right, how'd you do? The answer was the movie Zootopia. That's right, of course. It's a fox and a rabbit and a police car. Of course it's Zootopia. Hope you got it right. Here is our next emoji movie. Now this one's a little trickier. The answer is Alice in Wonderland. You got the little white rabbit who's always late, and the little caterpillar, and the Mad Hatter, and the Queen of Hearts. It's a movie, just a great movie. And here is our next emoji movie. I will admit, this one's probably the easiest one because it is the movie Cars. Obviously, it's the movie Cars. Of course it is. It's just a bunch of cars and a race flag. What else could it be? Cars 2? Maybe. No, but it's Cars. Great job. Here is our next emoji movie. This was a cartoon I watched a lot when I was a kid. Also a very famous book. It is Charlotte's Web with Wilbur the pig and Charlotte the web. No, the spider with the web. That's it. All right, here is our next emoji movie. It's a girl and an old lady in a shoe at midnight. Not a lot of options here. I think we all know what it is. It's Cinderella. That's right, Cinderella. Here's our next emoji movie. It's Coco. Of course it's Coco, obviously. Remember me. I can't sing it very well. Here is our next movie. Is there any kid that didn't get this? Which gave it away? Was it the two sisters? Was it the ice cube that's frozen? The snowman, the reindeer, all of it together? You don't know what I'm talking about because you've never seen this movie. Of course it's Frozen. Of course it's Frozen, everyone's favorite movie 6 years ago. All right, here is our next emoji movie. Now, this one's kind of an old one, but I'm pretty sure you've seen it. This is always on at the doctor's office whenever I take my kids to the doctor. That's the only time I ever see this. But it's Happy Feet, about a tap-dancing penguin. There's a reason you probably don't remember it. It's a tap-dancing penguin. All right, here is our next emoji movie. Did you get it? It is Inside Out. All the emotions inside this little girl's head. Emoji movie. That would be a tricky one. That one's not an option, but that would just be impossible because it's all emojis. Here's our next emoji movie. It is The Jungle Book. That's right, The Jungle Book. All right, we got a few more. See if you can get this next one. What is this movie? I think this one's pretty easy. Kung Fu Panda, skadoosh. That's right, Kung Fu Panda, with everyone's favorite panda, Po. Here is our next emoji movie. That's right, it's the movie Dogs Love Spaghetti. No, it's Lady and the Tramp. Well done if you got it right, and if you didn't, it's okay, not a big deal. Here is our next emoji movie. Hey, that's right, it's Hey Hey from Moana. Moana! Great job if you got it. We have one more, and I gotta be honest, this one's pretty easy. I think you can get it. Are you ready? Here is our last emoji movie. There's not a lot of mouse movies where people are cooking. It's Ratatouille. Ratatouille, that's right, it's Ratatouille. Well, thank you for playing our game. I hope you did well. We'll be back next week with a really fun game for you. But now it is time to go to our counselor sing-off. Now, we want to congratulate last week's winner. We had a contest between Sean Huffman and Gracie Sears, Sean singing the campfire song, and Gracie Sears singing the theme song from the TV show Hannah Montana, and with a landslide victory, congratulations to Gracie Sears. Well done. Now, I have to say, half of Gracie's votes came from people whose last name was Sears, but there's no rule against that. Gracie, you won just handily. Well done. Sean, I'm sorry. I liked your song a lot. It made my kids laugh. And then they voted for Gracie. But anyway, great job to Sean and to Gracie. A wonderful competition. But we have a brand new competition for you. Now, last week, we had our counselor sing a song from a TV show. Well, it's studio camp. So in this week's sing-off, we are going to have them sing a song from the soundtrack to a movie. Here comes the sing-off. First contestant is Austin. Austin was our green team counselor from last year. Austin is going to be singing a song from the Guardians of the Galaxy soundtrack. There's a lot of options to choose from, and he has chosen a good one. So here is Austin singing it out at his house. Austin, take it away. Sings in a remote like Austin, and he didn't just do that for the video. He does that every day, all the time. Here is our next counselor, Abby Vignell. Now, Abby is not just singing. Abby is also dancing as well, and actually, she would like you to dance with her. So I'll be doing it in my office. You do it in your home. Abby's going to do it in her home. Here is Abby singing a song from the Hannah Montana movie.
Hello, Camp Straight Street. My name is Abby, and I'm excited to do Counselor Sing-Off this week, and I'm going to be doing Hoedown Throwdown. Please feel free to stand up and dance with me.
Boom, clap, boom, de-clap, de-clap, boom, boom, clap. Boom, de-clap, de-clap, boom, boom, clap. Boom, de-clap, de-clap, boom, boom, clap. Boom, de-clap, de-clap, try with me, here we go. Boom, boom, clap, boom, de-clap, de-clap, that's right. Boom, de-clap, de-clap, boom, boom, clap. Glide, zigzag, cross the floor.
you perfect. Pop it, lock it, polka dot it, countrified in hip hop it. Put your honk in the sky, move side to side, jump to the left, stick it, glide.
Done, Austin and Abby. Now it is up to you to decide who wins our sing-off. Was it Austin singing Mr. Blue Skies, or was it Abby singing the Hoedown Throwdown? You need to decide. Vote here and let us know who the winner is. Now, last week I had the opportunity on our TV show, Straight Street Live, to sit down with a guy named Half a Horse. Long story, who is trying to kind of do some of the things at camp that we normally would have done, but since no one can be here to do it, he's doing it himself. Well, we want to check in with him and see what he is up to. Check it out.
People ask me, what makes a good cowboy? Is it his horse? Possibly his crew? But no. What makes a good cowboy is his rival.
It is I, the great Jean-Luc Pierre, and I am here to acquire your fantastic Camp Straight Street to make my own camp called France 2 Electric Boogaloo.
No.
Understandable. Have a nice day.
Who are you?
I am the great Jean-Luc Pierre, and I am here to buy this beautiful camp to create France 2 Electric Boogaloo.
No.
Well, who are you then?
I am Half Horse, the protector of this camp, and might I say that you need to leave now.
No. See, I need to take over this camp because there's obviously no one here. It's failing.
Keeping it safe until it starts back up.
Why is this not started now?
Well, that doesn't matter why it's not here now. What matters is that I keep it safe till it starts back.
Well, I am here to buy.
Well, it's not for sale.
Well, I talked to Jonathan, and he said... Well, actually, he said no, too. But I will figure out a way, legally, to take over this camp. And if I don't, I'll find another way.
Wait. There's a better way to do this.
All right. I will show you how rally is done for real. Oh. Okay. For my first activity, you.
Come up here. You're gonna play a game.
Do I have to?
Yes.
Oh.
Be given -50,000 if you do not play.
What? With, you will get this. 50,000 points. Okay. So, here is our first challenge. Grab the cards. And grab the con. And now, be doused. No. Away with you.
Oh.
Be gone, revolutionary. I win! Put the helmet back on.
Put the helmet on.
Nice one!
You're really bad at this, you know that?
Hold on, I have a secret weapon.
Oh no! Oh no! Oh!
I win!
Well, enough of that nonsense. It's my turn to host rally. For my rally, I'll need a guest. Anyone willing? Anyone? Anyone at all? Hey, you! Yeah, you, come over here.
Not again.
Well, howdy there, partner. We're gonna sing a little song together.
Oh, no.
Do you have a favorite song?
No.
No. Well, that was great. Alright, you can leave
that
now.
That was a great sing.
Yeah.
I like that a lot.
That's it for today's rally. Yeah. Goodbye.
Well, you now get to decide what happens next by telling us and voting who had the better rally. Was it Half a Horse or was it Pierre? You decide what happens next. So vote. Just email us and let us know, Have a Horse, Pierre, who wins, and see how it unfolds next week. Well, that is the end of our show. We want to leave you to know a couple things. One, next week is our dress-up contest, and it's Jedi Camp. So I want to see your Yoda costumes, your Rey and Finn and Poe, and get in a ball and be BB-8, be a Tauntaun, be a Wookiee, anything. It doesn't matter. It's Star Wars. It's like Christmas around here for us nerds. Get excited. That is Jedi Camp next week. Also, if you have an impossible shot,
We want you to send it in, and we want to use it right here on the show. If we like it enough, we use it. We'll send you a $5 gift card for Bluff Park Ice Cream. Well, that is the end of our show. We want to... Oh my gosh. This must be the end of the show. Wow. I only got... What? Oh, 15 seconds. I just want to thank everyone for making this possible. This award means a lot to me. Just work hard. Never stop believing. Have a great night. My kids, if you're watching on TV, go home. It's time for bed. You need to be in bed right now. Oh my gosh. Oh, I can't believe it. Thank you guys so much. This means the world to me. Thank you so much. Thank you.